Hi, I'm Michael from AES, and in this video we're going to explore the advanced settings and features using the AES PRO app. As an example, I'll be showing the settings section of the Cellcom Prime 7 intercom. Most, if not all, the settings are available for other intercoms in our GSM range. Firstly, you need to select your site and your intercom. From here, you have settings at the bottom with a cogwheel symbol. Once you tap on settings, a safety notification pops up stating you're entering the advanced settings page. Any changes made here can change how your intercom operates and may even result in the intercom no longer functioning. This is obviously an important notice, and certain settings here forward are vital to the intercom's ability to operate fully, so changes need to be made with care and understanding. In the advanced settings area, we have three different sections: caller ID, dial out, and intercom. In caller ID, we have a range of settings. Firstly, KPN caller ID. Again, we have a warning notification when selected. You will notice that KPN caller ID is enabled by default, but also there is a small information symbol on most settings pages here which explain the functionality of that setting. For KPN caller ID, it states that this feature is used to stop potential multi-triggering and is set as enabled by default. With this feature disabled, it will trigger and hang up immediately. This feature is enabled by default to avoid any potential network and multi-triggering issues. Caller ID Relay. By default, the caller ID function activates Relay 1. If you need to change this to Relay 2, you can enable Relay 2 here, as the relay will be triggered by the caller ID function. However, if you want the intercom from a phone number unknown to the intercom, as in unstored for the intercom's caller ID function, then you will still trigger Relay 1 by using your access control password, even if the caller ID function is set to Relay 2. DTMF is short for Dual Tone Multi-Frequency. This is a setting that protects you from accidental opening and latching of gates and entrances. So when you have decided to open the entrance, you need to press 1, 2 or 3 and follow it with a hash or pound button. This limits the potential of an accidental opening or latching. Alternatively, you can disable DTMF so that you don't need to follow up the hash or pound symbol. Open caller ID mode can be disabled or enabled here. This allows any phone number to call the intercom and trigger the opening of the entrance. In the dial-out area of the advanced settings section, you can control a few settings on how the intercom places calls to outside numbers. The first setting you can control is the ringing time. Here you can set the amount of time that the intercom calls a number before hanging up and calling the next number saved. This can be important to the rollover feature, as your cell phone may go to voicemail before the 20 seconds is up, and the unit will see this as an answered call. To stop this from happening, you need to tell the intercom to roll over to the next phone number in less time, not giving the phone the opportunity to go to voicemail. You can also change how long it takes your phone to go to voicemail via your cell phone, which is another option. The abort call feature is to allow the intercom to roll on and try calling the next phone number if a phone should go straight to voicemail. This may happen if the intercom is trying to call a phone which is switched off, out of battery, or may have no cell signal at the time that the call is placed. So this feature is set as default to 0 seconds and means that the feature is not active. We recommend a 1 to 2 second time delay so that the intercom can quickly move on to the next phone number in sequence once voicemail has been detected. The Do Not Disturb feature allows you to stop a visitor disturbing you via the call button. You can enable times and days of the week when the call button will not place a call to your phone. Crucially, any caller ID, prox cards and keypad passcodes will still function as normal, keeping the intercom functional for users with passcodes and numbers programmed on the intercom. You can also set the intercom to call an alternative number during times when the Do Not Disturb feature is on. This feature can be particularly helpful for homes where accidental or prank callers may be prevalent, giving you peace during the times that you need it. The talk time feature is used to make the intercom end the call after a certain amount of time. By default, this is set to 60 seconds. The purpose of this feature is to avoid unnecessary usage if the call is not ended by the user. Here in this last section, we have various intercom settings, the first of which is 4G network features. In this area, you can set the APN for your cell carrier's 4G network. APN stands for Access Point Name and allows the device to make data connections with your network carrier. Setting the appropriate APN can improve the signal of the unit, and you can easily find the APN of your provider online. Simply enter it in the field and then reboot the intercom for the APN to take effect. Below this, you have 4G mode. you can choose whether your unit connects to a 4G network via this feature. Choosing false will mean that the unit will not try and connect to a 4G network, and will use only 2G and 3G connections. This can be preferred by users who use a pay-as-you-go SIM, as they may not have 4G compatibility. However, 3G networks are being closed down by carriers globally. It has already started in the USA, and the UK are scheduled to follow soon. We recommend a 4G connection to make the best connection possible for the unit to work as intended. Automatic relay times feature allows you to trigger, latch, and unlatch your entrance during set times of the week. This feature is useful for times when your entrance is busy and doesn't need to be attended to. Simply select which relay function you want, which days you need, and time you want the action to occur. For the purposes of relays, the terminology can be confusing for homeowners. So latch means the relay connects and keeps the gate open. Unlatch means the relay closes and therefore the gate or entrance closes. So we want the entrance to open and stay open on weekdays. At 8 a.m, we need to select latch and select the weekdays, then select 8 a.m. Confirm this and send the SMS to the unit. This will open the entrance and keep it open from that time of the day each Monday to Friday. To have your entrance close again, choose unlatch and choose times and days. I will go with my entrance to open from 8 a.m. and close again at 10 a.m. Monday to Friday. In advanced settings, some of these features are intended to fix older technical issues for older devices. Most will never need to be changed unless our technical team has advised you otherwise. Modem auto reboot happens every 4 hours. The unit will reboot the GSM modem to ensure a continued connection to the nearest carrier mast. In exceptional circumstances, our technical team may advise using this setting for problem-shooting any potential issues. The keypad baud rate is another feature used for problem-solving on older devices which may have old and new parts which aren't communicating with each other as intended, such as an old keypad matched with a new PCB, or an old PCB with a new keypad. With personalised relays, you can use this feature to name your relays. This can benefit you if you need to remember which relay is for which entrance, and for any communication which is sent to you from the intercom, such as entrance status messages. The relay operation function stops the unit from sending replies such as confirmation SMS or SMS opening alerts, potentially saving any users who have a pay-as-you-go SIM package by limiting the amount of SMS messaging that the unit carries out. The notifications feature, when active, will have the intercom send you a notification via SMS whenever the relay is triggered. This notification can be sent to 4 numbers simultaneously, and the message sent by the unit can be personalized here. In the passcode section, you can change your programming passcode. This is the passcode that allows for changes to be made to the programming of the unit. We recommend that you change this for security purposes. In relay times, here you can change the relay times of the unit. This is useful particularly for relays that are used to control mag locks that may need to be programmed to trigger for a longer period of time. In the service call feature, you can program the intercom to make a call or send an SMS message to prevent deactivation of the SIM. This is a good feature for those entrances which may not be used for longer periods of time. Time synchronization. Typically, the unit can tell time via an internal time clock counter, which reads the time via SMS sent to the unit. This is important to keep activity logs and timed events accurate. In the volume settings feature, you can change a number of different volume controls for the unit. Speaker volume and microphone volume for the unit can be adjusted, which is useful in areas which may have loud traffic noise. Keypad, DTMF, and ringtone volume can also be adjusted if needed. In auxiliary settings are used for any auxiliary relays which may be attached to the unit. Their names and relay times can be changed via this feature. In the events log, you can change how many events you would like to see when you check the events log. By default, this is set to the last 20 events of the intercom, but you can set this as a maximum of 50 events if needed. Thanks very much for watching. If you need to know more, then comment below and we'll answer any questions as soon as possible. Anything else you want to know about the AES Pro app or our products, then just check out our YouTube channel for more.